Blackstone Audio presents The Politically Incorrect Guide to the Great Depression and the New Deal by Robert P. Murphy. To Bob Higgs and Bert Folsom, whose heavy lifting made this book relatively easy. Introduction. Everything you learned about the Great Depression and New Deal is wrong. If you are a typical American, you learned that the 1920s were a period of wildcat speculation, where the little guy was at the mercy of unregulated big businesses. You learned that the excesses of naked capitalism led to a great stock market crash, an horrific economic contraction, and skyrocketing unemployment. You learned that Herbert Hoover did nothing to alleviate the crisis, merely gazing coolly from his White House office as the laissez-faire market economy collapsed upon itself. You learned that the American people demanded government help and voted overwhelmingly for Franklin D. Roosevelt, whose stirring words provided hope and whose revolutionary programs provided recovery. Finally, to the extent your education deviated from the above account, you learned it was World War II, not FDR, that actually pulled the United States out of the Great Depression. Every single element of this official narrative is utterly false, and any honest researcher who bothered to check his primary sources would have known it. But most historians know nothing about economics, and most economists know little about history, or even about economics, if CNBC is any guide. The D.C. politicians and bureaucrats can always count on plenty of historians and economists who are only too eager to sing the praises of big government, even if the song's verses don't jibe with the facts. But so long as you don't let historical details trip you up, the Great Depression myths make for a great story. They contrast the indifferent do-nothing Hoover against the bold and charismatic Roosevelt. Even if, well, Hoover spent unprecedented sums on public works to create jobs, and, Roosevelt excoriated Hoover's profligacy on the campaign trail. But the change in presidents is just too good a hook for historians to hang their hats on, and gushing Roosevelt biographers have been only too happy to fill their readers' heads with hagiographies of the great man. This book is a guide to the most important period of American economic history, one that touches our fundamental understandings of how our economy works and what government should do. This book fact-checks the myths, shows how they're wrong, and will arm you with the truth. It is one of the great untold, or at least undertold, stories of American history. It is also a story that many in the government, the liberal media, and even academia do not want you to know. But it is the truth. You can look it up. And this book isn't just about history. Right now, the federal government and Federal Reserve are expanding their powers in unprecedented ways. The government is granting trillions of dollars in direct handouts and guarantees to the nation's biggest banks and corporations, while the Federal Reserve stands ready to pump tanker loads of money into the credit markets in the name of stimulating the economy. We're told the lessons of the Great Depression justify this racking up of enormous debt and this massive intervention of the federal government into what was previously known as the private sector. But the history on which the federal government's power grabs are based is simply a myth. This book will show you what really happened and arm you against the apologists for the federal juggernaut. It was big government, in alliance with some members of big business, that fueled the 1920s stock market boom and made the 1929 crash inevitable. It was even bigger government under Hoover and then FDR that kept tinkering with the market, delaying recovery, and leading us into the worst economic downturn in American history. And it could happen again if we're guided by myth rather than fact. The issues in this book are not mere disagreements between conservative and liberal, Republican and Democrat. Things are much more serious than that now. What happened in the 1930s is repeating itself in our times, with a growing chorus calling for a new deal. Only if enough citizens learn the truth in time will America avoid an even greater Great Depression. Chapter 1. The Crisis. Guess what? The standard account of the Great Depression relies on bad history. The myths of the Great Depression and New Deal support big government. The New Deal prolonged the Depression. The Great Depression is the most important event in American economic history. It drastically shifted American ideas of economics and politics, with the federal government taking a far more...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.